thanks for coming out on a school night. And hope that you trip out. Hey, we put some acid in for my boxes. So in about 15 minutes it should kick in. You're like, we'll see you all night. Someone's like, yes, I got bang for my buck.
Special effects.
Totally. Technical difficulties is a special effect. It's
exactly.
Like it's out of your control. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
to have my like underwear hang out. Because that stupid me forgot to like put on tights. But I am wearing underwear. At least it's like rated PG-13. Well, no, because I'm not shaped, so. Oh, wait a minute. Which way did that go? Whoa, that was out. Did people want to ask questions now, or just keep going until you go fucking crazy? Like, I'm gonna kill her, stop it!
Keep going.
Like, break down, like, I don't know what happened tonight, I didn't do it! It wasn't me! And then crawl behind bars, you know, it's like, thanks to you! It's just wine.
You sure it's not the acid you put?
I have so much leftover stuff in there. They say it never leaves your body. And it's weird because like I think it's still maybe my son got some of it, but I think some of it stayed inside. I didn't do all of it. It was before his time. And they say it's like, well, get your party over before you have kids, and it's like, yeah, but then you pass that shit on to them. It's stuck in your body forever, so it seems like you should have kids first and then go party so you can pass that. And I was like, oh, you've got ADHD, and it's like, well, no wonder. Like, you know, feel sorry for it. It's like, you are the drugs your parents took. Another form of epigenetics, like in another way. And on that note, my parents didn't do any drugs. Like, so I don't know where this comes from. It's like miraculous. Okay, now, I don't know, should I do something really gentle? And not so harsh? Like, gentle. I don't know, are you a sleepy mood? Like, it's like, oh, or, let's see.
When I touch a key, it makes a movie come up on the screen. And I can have as many as 15 different movies come up. And they were all made especially for this purpose. So when I...
And you touch a key on the piano.
Right.
Oh my gosh, I have to move further from you.
Not here, there.
Oh, there.
Not the
piano. I thought on this piano.
No. There's a keyboard over there.
Okay.
Of course, it's an electronic thing. So at any rate, that's... We won't use that the whole time because I think that the fan noise of the projector is a bit annoying, but maybe we'll do two takes with the fan on, and then you can see this thing that I'm working on, and then I'll shut the projector off. So, excuse me again. So I'll give you an example here. I press the second key. And I can get rid of these other sounds that... Okay, press the third key. Fourth key. I can go up to 15 note polyphony, but it's picking from 592 movies that I made. So even though there's only 61 keys on the keyboard, there's 592 movies, which means that if I hit a key a second time, it'll come up with a different movie. It won't play the same movie again.
Oh, Oscar Sella.
And it really has major problems, but it's still a fantastic thing. So I'm going to turn on one more camera and one more recording device, and then we'll get rolling. program on this before. It's not 5 minutes late, so let's go to the day and then start. Wait. Let me get this thing going.
Nothing's ever easy.
No, but the recording will be great. I love using this. Let's just make sure it's rolling. Could we have a moment of silence and then we'll start again? Because you started before I was totally prepared. Thank you. Oh, I particularly love that you came in the way you did at the end. It was very dramatic. But should we try another take?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's so fun, like a way to meet each other. Plug in.
Hey, how you doing?
Yeah, like, nice to meet you. It's sort of like being like it's like promiscuity in some way.
It's not quite a glory hole, but
it's like a musical promiscuity.
So you're saying you'll just play with anybody? That's what this is really about.
Yeah.
This is Lammy.
It almost seems like too good of a place to not stop.
Yeah, why force it?
This is...
this is Lammy, this is it.
Lammy.
Lammy was the name of a toy, a dog's toy. Alright, begin. Thank you.
Tell your son I've got an instrument he can play.
All of them.
Thank you, guys. We went to Lily, and then we went to the comic book store, and I got him some $1 comics, and he's looking at the ball.
Oh, that's a comic book.
Yeah, it was a cool store. So I got, like...
Where'd you go,
Ives?
No, they went to Copacetic.
Copacetic, of course.
Enough to, like, fit his budget.
Instruments, and that looked like it would totally be like the cousin of the baby bots, because it's like, yes, it's a bot, clearly it's a robot, but yeah, it's so good. And it has like a
it's cute.
Yeah, it is. And it exactly, and it has a lure on the front. Does it have a light sensor, or is it that just, okay. Yeah.
The nose.
The nose is the light sensor, yeah.
So,
yeah,
what do you think?
So good.
Did we have a usable take of any of this?
Yeah, I think there are moments inside there that there are usable things with the...
I might edit.
Edit away.
And edit, yeah, because, you know, like, there takes times for things to warm up. And then there are places where, like, oh, something goes, and it's a...
Okay, well, good.
I can't talk at the same time.
I'll give them back to you in a moment. So it's, we got volume here.
Yeah.
Pitch is here. So that's just another source. There's high and low range, and this is an LFO, so it'll either change like the blinkiness of the light, or it'll act like a volume LFO, and then you get into
the speed of it.
The speed, and then when it modulates,
wow.
That's when I really like it.
Is this a recent
like being
film?
At the dentist. Like this.
I'm gonna get that. I was still working at the high school, so I've had that for a good 8 or 9 years
wow.
now. He's had like 3 models since then.
Oh, so this somebody is, makes these as a kind of.
It's just. Thing? It's this one guy in Austin.
Oh.
I just like read a review in Electronic Musician.
Do you know his name?
Well,
he's from Austin.
Yeah.
Yeah. I just know that he goes by it's Bleep Labs, and I'm sure you can find the guy's name. He just refers to himself as Dr. Bleep, and he's got some other gadgets. I'm not sure if he's doing much in production right now, but. Like, the more recent models included, like, a CV out. The most recent one, you could actually send a feed in and use it as a effects processor. But this one can be so vicious that, like, I kind of like the primitiveness of it.
Mm-hmm.
She... And then there's your other friend here.
I need to be an octopus.
Yeah. What is that? It looks quite raw.
It's very raw.
Yeah.
This one's called a board weevil. 3 oscillators that are either, like, in parallel or modulating one another.
Mm-hmm.
High and low range, light sensors, contact points.
Okay, so you can do a little touch.
And a power starve. So it'll act like the battery is dying.
Huh.
So
which actually just gives it another effect.
Well, it makes it more unpredictable usually.
Okay. Yeah.
Where's the toilet?
Upstairs.
So you have to bear around to your left, and then you'll see a set of steps going upstairs. And then once you get upstairs, you'll bear to your right.
Oh, go ahead.
Oh, I love that. It has a very vocal quality to it.
And that's just with the little built-in speaker. It's, you know, I can send it into an amp, too. Mm-hmm. Here, let's give you a little volume here. I tend to like the star stuff best.
It's like dependable power starvation.
It is, yeah.
Like, you can get the effects that you would only have very temporarily, but you can kind of dial it in.
Except the battery's not necessarily dying. It's a little like it's inherently an improvising instrument, because even if you want to stand it, it's just
really almost nothing you can do.
You really can't control the entire. But that's the kind of thing.
Look! Yeah, go to the toilet, sit down, and look at what's across from me. I'm not even gonna say it's fucking hilarious. Go! Go!
It's gonna be a camera.
No, even better, no. Even better. It's quite the opposite of the idea of a camera. Go to the toilet.
There's not like a camera in the toilet.
It's just so funny. Like, I'm looking at it and I'm like, what? And then I pick it up to, and then I'm like, no fucking way. Like, oh my god.
It's the Braille Playboy. It's just
like, I thought that might be. Playboy. Yeah.
Oh, that's too good. Oh my god. Is that real though?
Yeah.
No way. Where'd you find that?
Where does he find any of this stuff?
Braille Playboy, that would be dedicated a great gift seeking idea for Otto, my blind friend. Oh, but is Braille different in the different languages, like between German and English? Because they must have to do
yes.
The, oh no, but they don't need to do the umlauts, because your way around the umlauted shit is to put the two vowels together.
I've never given it a moment's thought, to be honest.
I think that using the alphabet things are the same looking. Yeah, because you can get around, if you don't have the umlaut things, then you do it. Instead of the U with the umlaut, you have UE.
She's... Oh, yeah. Or is that...
Oh, no, she's just not... Okay. Oprah's got classic Incredible Hulk.
Oh, nice.
Like, old ones. Mm-hmm. He's totally... He's set.
Oh, yeah, there were free ones there, too.
Ooh. He's...
We got some bracelets, by the way, so he has two of these Black Lives Matter bracelets.
Oh, nice!
They were giving away on the condition that you would wear them. They're like, here, they're like, take one if you'll wear it. And he was like, can I have two? And it said, take one or more. So I was like, sure, you can have two, but you have to promise to wear them, or you have to give them to somebody else who will wear them. So he's wearing them.
Nice!
That was part of the, just letting you know that was part of the kind of obligation. No, I haven't told him
gosh,
that, but yeah,
he,
I should.
He follows the news and stuff with us, and if you explain it, it's like, remember, like, because he's heard it, like, on the radio.
Oh, right, yeah.
About it and stuff, yeah. Because he can't read
that's,
yet.
That's right, a small right. store, but it's really good.
Lily?
Lily's nice too. Yeah,
the mall, as it were. Yes.
Polish Hills Mall.
Yeah, totally.
All right, shall we record anymore, or shall we call it quits for today?
Well, the stuff's all set up and stuff.
I say let's do one more.
All right, that's what I think too. I'm loading up a different set of samples now. So as soon as this set of samples is loaded, I'll be ready to go again.
So, were you brought here by Duquesne once?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Manny brought her trio twice.
Is that who it is?
Trio twice.
Lundy at Duquesne, or am I getting the names mixed up?
She are you thinking of Lynn Purse?
Lynn Purse, that's who it is.
Lynn,
sorry,
Lynn
I
and
the names
Bill.
Mixed up. Lynn and Bill, yeah.
I.
She said she was going to come last night, but maybe she didn't make it, though.
Yeah, she's kind of, they're kind of unreliable in that
respect.
Well,
I know that they're probably, like, you know, busy.
They're pretty busy people, but when, like, I teach at Carnegie Mellon, but I never got a graduate degree, and the former head said, you know, maybe you ought to go and do that. So I was, you know, I spent I think it was just shortly after you appeared there that I got my grad degree. So Bill was my advisor, and I had to take classes with Lynn too. So I know them anyway. Bill's younger brother is an old friend of mine.
Okay, they're really nice couple.
They're very nice.
And they hosted my bandmates and me. Because there's a couple.
They treat people right. You know, when they bring in artists, they do treat them very nicely. And she has a history playing with David Burden, who's kind of like a synthy
minimalist. Yeah. Mother Mallard.
Mother Mallard.
Mother
she
Mallard,
played in. She played in.
Well, yeah, because I went to see what she was up to lately, and I went to her site because she got on my mailing list thing and was like, oh, they're coming to Pittsburgh and the blah blah blah, and then I went to her site to check out the thing, and it was like, wow.
Are you close or?
I'm up to D sharp 6.
Okay.
Now E 6. So yes. Close.
So I was looking over your Facebook page, of course.
Is it under your regular name?
Did you friend me yet on Facebook?
Not yet. No.
Oh, we have to friend.
We will.
But we're like real friends. See, we were just talking about Facebook. Like, there's a bunch of people I don't know on there.
Oh,
I've
got
people I know, and then it's like a mixture and. And then I tried to make a fan page, but still people go to me, or the people that are on me, you know, refuse to go to the fan page. I tried to invite them there.
Yeah.
And once you've started the thing before the fan page existed, you're kind of stuck with, like, you know, and then I wanted to figure out, but I just don't have time, like, to make a separate one that's, like, where it's, like, real, like, you know, friends, family, like, content, like, where it's, like, like, to make it more tight-knit.
Yeah, yeah. The name the other name that came up was Lena Alamano. She's a
she played
trumpet
viola.
Player.
Yeah,
she did. Yeah, she's been spending a lot of time in
my
Europe.
Friend Chris, my bandmate. Had his studio because they had a hard time finding a gig in Vienna.
Yeah,
Vienna's
yeah.
a nut, like, it's such a weird place. I'm treated so like garbage there, and like, you know, the band is, and it's just like, and some of the most interesting things pass by Vienna and don't go through.
I've actually brought Lena in a couple of times.
Oh, she's great.
She's,
over.
Fun with her.
Thing is, all these devices are running, and they are all running out, so I'm trying to record before.
Okay, how's your status here?
Well, I'm ready to go.
Okay.
Well, I saw it because I'm left-handed.
All right, I'm ready whenever you are.
Oh, he's playing with it now.
So let's try one more take.
Okay.
Thank you.